stood still, looking sad. That may be the sentence in this gospel lesson that makes most sense. Cleopas and his unnamed companion are walking down the road from Jerusalem to Emmaus, talking about everything that had happened, talking about everything that's been going on. I imagine there was a great deal of sadness. Their Lord had been executed. Their hopes, their dreams, they thought were dashed. And then Jesus shows up. He says, "What y'all talking about?" And Cleopas says, "Man, where have you been?" And he, what I imagine, coming out in a rush. When Jesus says, "What things are you talking about?" The things about Jesus of Nazareth, who was a prophet, mighty in word and deed, and I imagine I can see the emotion. Probably broken with sobs, broken with pauses, not sure where to go, not sure what to say. We don't know what's going on. And we heard this weird story about an empty tomb and a vision of angels, and we don't know what to believe anymore. And Jesus says, "Oh, how foolish you are, and how slow of heart to believe all that the prophets have declared," which is Jesus' kind and patient way of saying, "I told you all these things over and over and over again while I was alive. Because they had heard it." But sometimes hearing the good news over and over and over again doesn't quite do it for us. Maybe we latch on to the intellectual piece, trying to make sense of it. Maybe we latch on to this or that or the other thing. Maybe there are all sorts of distractions. Maybe the good news, like it was for Cleopas and his unnamed companion, was really far more than we ever imagined it to be. So Jesus tells them one more time, all the things, beginning with Moses and all the prophets, here is what is going on. Here is what God is doing. This is the way God is bringing about a new reality. The risen Christ shows up always and everywhere, just where we need the risen Christ to show up. It's what's striking about this story. So as they get to Emmaus, as they get to their destination, they invite this stranger, still unknown to them, their risen Lord, to have dinner with them. When he was at the table with them, he took bread, blessed it, and broke it, and gave it to them. He took bread, he blessed it, he broke it, he gave it. I don't think I need to tease out what's going on there. I think it's an intentional Eucharistic reference. Already, by the time Luke's Gospel was written, they were celebrating the Eucharist. Celebrating. But during this time, when we're not able to gather for the Eucharist, what strikes me the most is not so much the ritual undercurrents here, but the fact that they were just sitting down at the table and having dinner together. I think sometimes we look for Jesus in spectacular ways. We look for the risen Christ in, you know, letters of fire 50 miles high in the sky. But really, when our risen Lord shows up, it can be in the simplest most mundane, everyday, quotidian, day in and day out sorts of ways. Because that's what happens. Jesus shows up where we need Jesus to be. We don't have to go looking over here, looking over here, looking up here. In the everyday things, God is working out God's plan, making us whole, making us new, bringing us home, and showing us that new reality, even now, in the simplest of things. Dinner with friends, dinner with family. Connections in God's community during a very difficult time. Connections via the technology of the day. Live streaming morning prayer, Jesus shows up. Live streaming compliment, Jesus shows up. I think we're finding that God uses all the things of this world to reach out to us. That the risen Christ shows up and walks along with us and tells us as many times as we need to hear it, this is the good news. This is what the kingdom of God looks like. Sit down, they have dinner, and their eyes were opened. They recognized him and he vanished from their sight. They said to each other, were not our hearts burning within us while he was talking to us on the road, while he was opening the scriptures to us? And then they got back to Jerusalem, they found the 11, and they heard, the Lord has risen indeed, and he has appeared to Simon. Then they told what had happened on the road and how he had been made known to them in the breaking of bread. Jesus shows up. Jesus